Just after midnight on July 31st, a major landslide occurred in British Columbia within Canada, resulting in the complete blockage of the major Chilcotin River. This large landslide caused the river east of the slide to completely dry out, while to the west, the river pooled to a vast size, being unable to break through the landslide material, thus creating an ever-expanding lake. In the 5 days since, this lake has expanded to become up to 27 meters or 89 feet deeper than the typical river level, causing it to stretch upstream for 9.2 kilometers or 5.7 miles. Due to rightfully placed fears that the associated landslide dam could partially collapse, causing the lake water to rapidly drain away, evacuations and alerts were triggered along a 532-kilometer-long stretch of the Chilcotin and Fraser Rivers, ranging from 10 kilometers northwest of Hanceville all the way to where Vancouver meets the Salish Sea. Initially, I was worried that as much as 20,000 people could be at risk if this disaster was to soon occur, a figure larger than the mere 23 people that had been evacuated at the time. Well, I have some good news, as the local government has just released figures of heights revolving around a hypothetical worst-case scenario flood from this landslide dam. And these figures are not only less than half of what I was initially anticipating, but they decreased with distance much faster than I expected. With this in mind, I will now present the worst-case scenario flood heights with an added bit of context. For each region, these flood heights are compared to the yearly freshet or maximum yearly river height associated with spring or early summer melting of snowfall and glaciers. I did add in some additional numbers in between official figures, so keep this in mind. So, instead of up to 20,000 people being placed at risk, how many individuals are actually in potential imminent danger when this eventual collapse does occur? About 100, although this doesn't include at-risk areas west of the landslide where the lake is expanding in volume. Vancouver will see a maximum flood of 30 centimeters, 100 centimeters in Boston Bar, 150 centimeters in Lytton, 180 centimeters in Lillooet, 2 meters near the Fountain Indian Reserve, with flood heights only potentially surpassing the yearly average freshet flood heights 12 kilometers east of Hogback Mountain. Thus, truly unusual floods and damage could only occur further upstream of this location. This means 3.5 meter floods east of Game Ranch, 4 meter floods where the Chilcotin and Fraser Rivers join, 10 meter or 33 foot high floods at the Farwell Canyon Bridge, and possibly 15 meter or 49 foot high floods just east of the recent landslide edge. So, do these values indicate that it is completely safe to, for example, go kayaking on the Fraser River in Vancouver when a flood is ongoing? Absolutely not. This is why the entire river currently has active flood warnings, flood watches, and high stream flow advisory alerts. So, how long will this flood take to occur? While initial reports suggested a time frame within 48 hours, I was a bit skeptical of this, and what do you know, that period has passed. Instead, the unfortunate answer is we do not know, and you are not going to like this, but it could even take as much as a year for this dam to breach, as shown by the 377 days it took for a smaller landslide to be breached after a landslide in Indonesia in 2012. While such a time frame is probably unlikely, it could occur. The most expensive damage this looming disaster could potentially cause is the collapse of the Farwell Canyon Bridge via eroding the ground surrounding its base. The landslide dam is likely to be first overtopped by the expanding lake before a collapse occurs. During the last 48 hours, an evacuation alert, meaning a notice warning people of the potential need to evacuate at a moment's notice, was issued for a 51.16 square kilometer region, while the official evacuation zone was expanded in three areas to cover an additional 15.36 square kilometers. Also, this same time frame has seen multiple videos and photos posted on social media showing that the landslide which occurred has continued to expand, with multiple smaller landslides being observed. I will now end this video with a comparison to a better-known Canadian landslide. While the July 31st, 2024 Chilcotin River landslide had a volume of between 9.3 million and 18 million cubic meters of rock, The more famous Hope Landslide in 1965 had a volume of 47 million cubic meters.